Father in heaven, we praise your holy name today as we gather to partake in our elected government. Lord, we gleefully and joyfully acknowledge that you are the master of the universe, the master of your creation. Lord, we pray that you grant us wisdom and your guidance in the decisions made today. Lord, we thank you for the blessing of living in this great county, this great state, and this great nation. We thank you for the blessings you bestow on us each day. Lord, help us to be good stewards of your creation. I offer this prayer in the name of your Son and our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
People moved out of the county. Mm-hmm. I think you can attribute most of it to that.
Mm-hmm. You would think.
Grand total for payday was $1,042,177.51, and the total for payroll was $483,977.74. Have any questions?
Yeah, you can look through this paper quite a few times and not pick up too much.
I didn't see, did I overlook it? Can you check and see? Usually we get a cover sheet on the front of this that tells you what the wages were and the benefits were. Could you hold it on there this
time? I didn't see it either.
Could you provide wages? Well, yeah, she usually has a cover sheet before we get to this part that outlines.
You mean this?
I
file.
Oh, okay.
To shred it?
Yeah.
Pay a lot to get the thing shredded.
Mm-hmm. It is not cheap. That's why that big fancy truck that they use at used comes around.
Well, yeah, I didn't know if we paid them just a flat
fee
or
I thought it was by time.
And I don't know if they come every month. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't
know. Okay, Jeremy will explain that. It was from the Main Street building. Yeah.
Oh, for that. All that old darkness.
Yes.
Okay, that
yeah.
I was wondering what a bike like that.
So, and since we were required to have it shredded on site, it cost more because they had to bring in the truck to have the shredding on the truck.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So, the bill is actually a little bit higher, but they had told us that they could do it all in one trip with one truck. It ended up being three trips, and so we are still working on the trip fuel charge for the other two. So that actually is not the full payment of the invoice. There's still $515 to pay that we're hoping that they'll just waive those fees. So that's what that is.
Three trips, huh?
Yeah, it was a ordeal. Mike really did a great job keeping that coordinated. Big mess. Gotta clear it out though.
Wasn't a lot of those documents old court documents?
They were. Mm-hmm. Actually, this whole bill, that's what that was. Because the health department and planning and zoning, the little bit of documents they had, that was incorporated into the shredding pickup that we have every 4 weeks there that gets paid out of the courthouse.
But otherwise they pick up once a month?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We just pay them a certain amount once
yes.
a month?
Uh-huh. And that goes by how many bins. And so we normally have four bins. And so I think that's $128. So.
Yeah, I forgot about all of that documents.
Yes, yes. So, yeah, that was a big project, and
thank you for the information.
Sure.
When you're talking about safety, so you
yeah.
Anybody
else have anything?
We have some change orders.
Okay. Administrative business? I guess we're already into that.
Yeah. Have the minutes.
Does that suffice for what you was asking for, Diane?
Yes.
Okay, we have the minutes of the March 18th meeting. I will go ahead and make a motion to approve those as written, with as amended. Second, all in favor?
And then I also have minutes of the 25th, March 25th.
Okay. March 25th, any additions or corrections? Okay, as health insurance contribution, we need to have some discussion on that to approve the plan, but not the employee contribution as it stands right now at 10%, which will affect that contribution to the employees. Got the printouts from Tuna in regards to the increase and also what we want to do on the family. So both nets out at 3% increase.
So I just have a question. And that is, I just would like to know, based on the plans that were presented, and especially the ones that I presented to the end on the Aetna plan, realizing, if you really studied, and I assume that you probably didn't have the time to really study them. Well, I know you did, because you didn't see them until I presented them that day. It was a stunning plan. That Aetna plan was stunning. And I just feel really bad. But I don't think we've done the employees any justice. I mean, we had the opportunity there to reduce their premium down to almost nothing, save the county $50,000, and still have very good protection for the employees. And so I just don't understand. So I would just like to ask each of you why you were so dead set on Blue Cross. I mean, I just would like to know.
I'm going to tell you right off the get-go, I haven't talked to an employee once. As long as it's reasonable that we can afford, they're going to have to step up a little bit too to keep the same plan, I mean, percentage-wise and things like that. That's why I voted, if you notice my motion was the same 10%, built straight across. And I think, also, like I told you, I visited with a couple of insurance people, that pharmacies. I visited with two out of three. And the third one I haven't had a chance to visit with. I think Aetna has a name, the way it sounds, that insurance papers is tough for them people to deal with. Aetna, I think, both of them did say that they're improving a little bit on their insurance forms and things that the pharmacies have to file. But they're still not as good as Blue Cross and Blue Shield. So those two things, really, and both of the pharmacies Hillsborough's never contacted me, but Marion and Peabody has. And so I have not talked to Hillsborough. But neither one of them said, if you visit with either one of those two, either Marion or Peabody. So I think you made the statement you visited with somebody the other day. So
I have.
Yeah.
I was talking to the health care provider. I did make a misstatement, and that was when I was talking about the rest of the plan, which was the best way. And through the information that I got, I guess, on the people's responsibility, I guess I misunderstood. But I was under the impression through the rest of the plan that in fact, the person had a heart problem, like the rest of the heart, and you had a doctor right now for Kansas heart, and then you take the rest of the program that you couldn't take your doctor. I was wrong. That's not a true statement. The Wesley plan is only the facility. The doctors do go there. So if you had a heart doctor right now and had a heart attack or something like that, you go to Wesley, you still have your doctor. Which I didn't know that. And I said that you would have to get a different doctor, and that was not correct. But I was just looking at the premiums, I was looking at the out-of-pocket, I was looking at the benefits. $100,000 difference is just amazing. I mean, that's a lot of money when you have another plan. So I was just curious as to why you did that. I don't doubt that, you know, some of the things Blue Cross had a $5 more copay, or Aetna had a $5 more copay, or one of them, but the whole big picture. You know, when you could get a $500 deductible and have a $1,500 out of pocket. And there's a lot of companies around here that sell Aetna. Maybe last year United had struggles, and I can accept that a little bit better, but Aetna has always been at one of the top insurer providers. And I just think we missed an exceedingly good opportunity to keep taxes down and provide, and Tina made a statement that you need to reduce the employee contribution. Well, yeah, because we don't have 51,000 to play with and still stay the way we are. So I just didn't understand why it was just blown away. And so I asked. So
well,
what your reason was?
I talked to employees, and I did contact a hospital administrator. I didn't contact both of them because I'm not sure who the hospital administrator in Hillsborough is. But, you know, I wanted to know from the hospital side and the clinic side their accounting and claims, because they've worked with all of these people now. And they... You know, of course, the hospital administrator here was adamant that it streamlines their costs, their claims, and collection. Blue Cross and Blue Shield, he said, are just hands down the best when it comes to that, and employees having to hassle with getting on the phone and trying to contact somebody, and then being on a phone for hours and hours. I've had some of those situations myself, and what the hassle it goes through, and just the comfort level that the employees seem to have. And, you know, if they had Aetna for 5 or 10 years, maybe they'd have a comfort level for them too. I don't know. But, you know, based on the conversations that I've had, I just, you know, felt like that if we can continue to try to work with Bruce, and I know Bruce, he can't make the decision, but he's done a great job of trying to represent the county and keeping it down somewhat, although, you know, I know he can't go on forever.
I think you've seen last year we made that decision that it was too much for us, and I think if that happens to us, we'll have to make that decision. I'm not going to say that we won't. I'm just saying that I don't think we're there yet, but last year was a year that we saw what we was facing, and we made that change, and then they come back and got within a reasonable amount. So.
Plus, it concerns me that, you know, the last few years our claims have gone up.
That's
a bunch. And, you know, I know we have a lot of employees that have been here a long time. I'm not saying we're unhealthy at Marion County. I don't know, but claims have been going up.
Well, that's a good one. I understand that the insurance run. I would ask, though, that next year when we do this, I think it will be fair. If we're going to get the employees involved, I noticed, you know, we have, you know, half of them 2,100 employees here. I would ask that next year we actually give all the employees an opportunity, because these dozen or two, that's not fair. And I would also suggest that the employees actually see the plans, and then let the before we have a decision, and let the employees look at what we're looking at. I mean, if you're going to have the employees involved at all, it's only fair to have all the employees involved. And if the employees are going to be involved, then they need to be informed.
Well, there's this right here, these are accessible, but all of our field employees don't usually get a chance. And we did reach
right.
Officers mm-hmm. come in last year, but there again, they're right over here. We don't have our chance for our field employees to...
That's right. That's why I say maybe, you know, like when we get the first initial thing, we could send it to them, or put it in whatever. We could send them the packet or hand it to them. However, we would have to do that so that everybody had it in their hand and they could look at it for a week and then submit their results. We did a survey. Oh, I know, when we did that healthy dinner thing with Deidre, where she was put on how many participants and how many like this and how many like that. And that was a fair thing. All the employees had the opportunity to express. I just don't like to see, you know, a few employees setting a standard for all the employees, because they didn't even know what they were looking at. They didn't look at all the options. They just know. They just
know
what they
I
know
what Tina had sent her spreadsheets out to the department head so she could give it to the employees.
Okay, and I would go, I'm asking that, I'm saying that they need to actually see by this right here, this actual thing that was provided, rather than the spreadsheets and that.
Well, we probably need to try to start that process a little earlier if we can, but you know, I know sometimes it depends on when Blue Cross gets their quotes out to us too.
And I say that because, not to be disrespectful now, I appreciate the spreadsheets, but the spreadsheets are very concise and it does not give you a full picture. If you're looking for insurance. I mean, there's some people that would have loved to have the ball savings ones and some of those. I talked to them, they have them at other places where they work and they love them. It wouldn't have been a thing for me, but they didn't even know the options that we had for those, all the options. And then the details of the plan, they didn't know that. And true, it would be a little bit of information to pass out, but in all fairness, I just think we need to treat all employees the same and give them the same opportunity. That's just my opinion. It's just a suggestion for next year, because I know a lot of employees, you know, they, when I'm questioned about it, asked about it, a lot of them, oh, I didn't know that. Well, no, they didn't. And so, especially if it's going to be an employee-driven decision, I think the employee should be fully informed. They can email it. As a matter of fact, that's a simple thing. You can email those. Those entire packets, just like we got that entire packet, all that stuff could easily be emailed to every employee. So I just think that's something that we need to do.
I'm going to ask one more question while we're talking about that.
Sure.
Was everybody, what was her feelings about Sally, was her name?
Yes, Sally.
Gallagher?
Mm-hmm.
What's everybody's feelings about that? I don't know. Very efficient. But yet when I find out that Aetna pays money for, if we switch to Aetna, that Aetna would pay her money to do that.
If we hire her, we didn't have to.
Yeah, I know, but I'm just saying if that was to happen,
mm-hmm.
I understand that they would pay money to her. That's not fair to me.
You mean like a commission for generating the business form?
Yeah.
To be a consultant, she would provide us other services as well. She would actually have been a benefit consultant, which would have been broader.
Yeah, yeah.
It's not just that she gets a kickback from it. It's not like that.
Well, you and I both know that it puts money in your pocket.
Well,
how would you feel?
I think Bruce gets paid by Blue Cross and Blue Shield.
Who?
Bruce.
Well,
yeah,
of course he gets
yeah.
paid. Yeah, he works for him.
Mm-hmm.
But
yeah.
I'm saying, for an outside consultant, if you're neutral, you're neutral. If you're not, you're not.
Okay, but I think if I'm understanding it correct, she gets paid by, that consultant agency gets paid by all the ones they represent. And then whoever wins, somehow they're all involved, or they wouldn't be bidding with her.
That's not the answer that I got, so
I'll check into that and find the
fact,
because I'm
going to hire somebody, I want them neutral. I mean, I don't want them to be influenced.
way it is. I think we're misunderstanding, but I'm not going to comment on it because I don't know for sure, but I guarantee you I will find out. But I didn't get that impression. I realized she presented a contract to provide a service going forward, and what those details of their service was, I don't know. But
yeah,
she did not receive a dime for what she did consulting part there. So I guess I'll have to find that out. But anyway, I just wanted to know because I truly believe in this.
Okay, well, let's move on. We do need to talk about what the employee contribution is going to be for the coming year. I said right now we're 10% mark, and Tina gave us some information in regards to the family. What did it go up? 100?
No, it's 100. Blue Cross and Blue Shield went up $58,000.
Yeah, but I mean for employee, for example.
Oh, you're asking for the okay.
Was it 100 some dollars?
Well, Tina's got, based on page 1 and page 2, that the increase is 3%, which, I mean,
that's
23,088 and 27,094 of the family.
Okay, so based on this, if you go by number, are you giving an option 2? Because on option 2, the family used to be $1,515, and now it's $1,598. So it's about $85 increase.
Well, it went, it's going.
I'm looking, it was $1,515. You see it? On the sheet that's, okay, I'm not looking at that one. I'm looking at this original one that Tina gave us.
Well, she's got here the family's. With the last year contribution of 306.15, and it'll go to 330.
Well, that's your
okay. So for a current family for option 2 is 15.15.61. That's the total. That's not writing out what county pays or employee pays.
Right.
If you go down, if you're looking on this big sheet that she printed out, you get option 2 for family, $1,563.74.
Okay, so I guess I have to ask the question, and this is what always, this is another thing that I have a real beef about. I don't understand how we're going to look at the 15, which is current.
That's right. Yeah.
And actually, at this point in time, okay, so then you're going to look at option 3 to see something different. So why don't we stay with option 2 to see what that is, and see what we need to adjust on option 2. That's what confuses me. So if you go... If you look at the current in option 2 and then look at the increase in option 3, I mean, that's kind of an entirely different animal. You understand what my question is? So I'm saying, I'm looking at this sheet right here. It says currently we're paying $15.15, and I guess you said you're paying 10% for the employee. The employee's paying 10%, am I right? The premiums.
Yeah, 10%.
No, it wouldn't be 10%, because 10% would be $150, and they're only paying 91 or something like that.
That's for option 1. For single, you're paying $91.
Okay, you're paying 7 something?
Okay.
Now you're on the green sheet.
Let me go get the one.
Is it what? This gets so confusing with so many sheets and stuff.
Do you want to know what people pay currently for option 2, for family or for single?
Oh, I guess the question was, option 2, yeah, single, I want to know what they're paying. Currently they're paying $661, right, for option 2, for a single?
Okay, for option 2, $661.80, yes. Which makes it to where the employee only pays $71.15.
Okay. And what's the spend you're paying on that then? so now tell me the same thing with the increase. 705, now that...
So if we go with the... with this one, not the highlighted one, we go with this one, the option two, the total for health and dental is 736.87. Can you all see that? No.
Yep. Bottom left hand corner.
Where you at?
On this spreadsheet.
Option two.
Option two, the health and dental equals 736.87.
Okay, but now wait a minute.
So, and then...
Well, we're still on option two, right?
Correct. And this is the new plan.
Okay, so?
And 10% of that, just rounding it up to $74.
Yeah.
Okay, but this says right here, on this is just for the, okay, it says right here on option two,
okay.
That's the, that is still the $1,000, $2,000 deductible, correct?
Correct, is that right?
Okay. So this right here is saying that the renewal price would be $705.75, and this is saying $690 on the single. That's where I'm lost. This is saying the health insurance is $690 for the single, mm-hmm. and on this sheet it says it's $705 for the renewal price.
Yeah, and I don't know what
was that the one that she first got before he negotiated that lower?
That could be.
No, this is a 6.3 increase in this one. That's what they have. 6.3. Right? That's
well,
the last I heard.
Something's not adding up because,
no.
And then if you go over to the discussion sheet that she wrote up, I mean, she's only showing it. 3% on family and single of $2,308.27.94.
And she even shows up here, it says overall 4% increase for Blue Cross and Blue Shield. The last sheet that we received was on Monday, and it's this one right here that says 6.3% increase for Blue Shield. And if you even go down, and if you're saying that a 3% to the county and 3% to the city, to the employees, that would mean it would be a 6% increase if it's a fair division. Mm-hmm. So it would be a 6%. So I don't know why she has overall 4% increase in these costs up here. I mean, it doesn't add up. None of it does. And then these figures over here don't match.
It says
this here.
This says you can see that the employee's contribution rate has increased 4-5% depending upon the plan.
Right. This correlates with our overall 4% increase in Blue Cross of Blue Shield, which is overall 6.3%. So I don't, it just doesn't come out. I tried to work on a little bit myself at the house. I couldn't match them up, figure it up. It just, I couldn't.
But these are the actual numbers that are
yeah, the current rate. The current, but the current
well,
right
the new one, I mean.
That's these
those
are these
the
new rates.
But how can this be the new rate if this right here says that it's something? Because this is what we voted on with 34. So how could this be the new rate that I'm scrolling? And even this statement right here, I looked at this and I thought, what was she talking about there? The additional annual cost to the county is approximately $4,007.
That's all the family.
That's if you go to this one, if we added more to the extra contribution that the county pays. So if you look at this big one, so the top is the current. You get on to the second, Blue Cross Blue Shield plan is number one, change the drug plan. The increase is $23,087.64. You get on to the third one where it says family friendly. If we change what the county contributes, the extra
So that says 2794.
Which, what was budgeted was 885,000, and the total comes to 821,748.
Right. Yeah, so I mean, I knew we were under what we had budgeted for.
So then this up here for page one, it shows $23,088 for the year. And is that on option? Is that the option one? It says option
that
two.
That is
option two.
But here in our Blue Cross packet that we had received, here are the rates that you guys chose. You all look that out.
Only what?
Oh, over here is what the rates that we wrote chose. Who is this? It says with the 2.5 competitive concession, where'd that come from?
That's what he was talking about when he came in and said that the initial quote was, what, 6-point-something increase?
Yeah.
And then he got a concession on that.
Yeah.
So that was where you're talking about coming out with the 3% increase. Because I think that initial printout we got was for the full 6% increase.
Yeah, because that's what they presented that day, yes.
Right, but he told us he got a concession on that.
You would you like to copy that?
And that's it. Yeah, I've never seen that before.
No, he said that he got that lowered.
Mm-hmm. And that kind of correlates then a little bit with what Sally said on the Aetna too, because they were less.
I remember him saying that he'd gotten the concession, and he was actually surprised himself. But, you know.
So it would have been nice if he had one. He would have showed us a different sheet.
Yeah, because the first thing we got was for the full increase.
Yeah.
So Steve is over here.
So all these other spreadsheets then can kind of go away, huh? Study a bunch of spreadsheets while you're there?
What?
You want to study a bunch of spreadsheets?
What the questions are.
You come up with the questions. You study it, you come up with the questions.
My ears are plugged up. I can't hear very well. Maybe that was my car.
Okay, so. Okay, so I'm sorry, which sheet then do I need to see what the employee
is? Okay, Tina,
I need all these?
Yes, those are the new ones. So as you can see, we plugged in the numbers for the single, the family, and then full.
So now, I'm sorry, it says on option one, the county currently paid $616 on that one? Is that what that's telling me?
For the health and for the dental, it's $4662, which comes to a total of $662.87, plus $31 extra for $306.15.
the employee.
Yeah, the county contribution on the family friendly would be 330.
So this one right here then. This one right here then. Okay, so it's an extra increase of 330.
It goes from 306 to 330.
Extra.
No, that's the total. It's 306.15.
County's contribution.
To another 330.
So you're saying the county's, for this option number one, you're saying that the county is only paying $330.
No, the county pays $662.87.
Okay, that's what I
said. Plus the
330. Okay, that's what I said. The county is paying an increase of 330 for that plan.
It's not an increase. The increase is...
okay, so right now the county is paying $662.87, right?
Currently? Or do you want...
I'm on this green sheet that you gave me.
$662.87.
That's what we're paying now.
But we will be.
Well, we're paying 616 right now, right?
Currently, we are paying $634.86.
Okay, so now you're going to have to add the $330 to it, right? So we're going to be paying $992. The county's going to pay $992. That was my point. We've got to add, we're paying this, plus we have to add this. Okay. So now our cost goes up an extra $330 a month.
It's like $20, $25.
It goes up less than $30.
Currently,
our family plan, what are we paying for that?
Okay, option one, currently, for families, a total of $1,662.10. The county pays $634.86 and then is doing an extra $306.15. So then when you go to this, it changes to $662.87 and then to $330. The difference between $330 and $306.15 is roughly $25.
Okay, so I'm sorry, I'm so stupid on this. Why am I so lost? So I guess it says county extra, $330.
Uh-huh. We were doing an extra of $306.15.
Okay.
And we're trying to make it family friendly to just raise it up to $330, adding $25, so that, as you can see off to the side, if we keep it at the $306.15 for family, it's $27.98 increase. If we add the $25 for family for option one, it's an increase of $4.13. So we're just trying to make it a little more family friendly.
What is the total that the county pays? If the total the county pays, it was $900 right?
Our family.
Our family.
Yes.
Okay. And but the total, it also on the single, because it said 616 plus the 330.
No, single is just the it would be the total of $662.87, which then for employee paid single is $95.92. That county extra is only for family.
Oh, okay, so it's just for the family?
Yes, like it's that extra.
Why did the family plan go up so much and not the single then?
More exposure, I suppose. I don't know.
Okay, I can see that that just said simply because of the family that we pay an extra $330.
It used to be where the single was all paid for by the county.
Mm-hmm.
And then we started having the singles pay some. And so then that was where we got the extra. I think we did the extra before we made singles.
There's,
but then that was a way to add more to the extra.
We went from $50 or $75, or maybe paying nothing for the family plan at one time.
Correct. Well, we paid for the single Yes,
you paid the difference.
We paid the employee, but the employee had to pay for the scanner.
The difference, yes. And then we went to like $50, $75. We've done it twice or three times. I don't know. We've upped the family side of it to try to, because see, the employee still pays this far column out to the right for a family plan, correct?
Right.
$600, $691, $641, depending on what option you're in.
Right.
Correct.
Yeah. And.
You're on a different page than I am.
Or well, even this page right here, the yellow highlights. Yeah, they're still paying $667, $667, $617, or you drop down to the bottom.
So to add that extra $25 to the family plan, the county would pay is $4,006.80. Which comes to a total of $27,094.44 increase. But that, if you look what's budgeted and what the total would be,
I think when we budgeted, we figured we were going to have maybe more than 6% increase.
So this right here now is telling me here, on the single, your suggestion, if I'm reading this right, is that we only increase the single health plan by $4.16.
This is what the employee.
Yes.
The employee pays. The single for option one, the single would be an increase of $4.16. Family would be an increase of $4.13. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, if you look at this, the other one where the county extra stays the same, the employee is $4.16 still, and then the family is $27.98.
Okay. And so that one right there is. Oh, that's okay, but this is, you're saying that that's if it was the same, it just stayed the same.
Correct.
Okay. I guess that's what confuses me a lot. Confuses me a lot going back to that, because to me that's irrelevant, because that's not going to be that way.
What's not going to be that way?
You said it stays the same.
We're showing you two different things. So the current on the county extra would pay $306.15 extra for the family. If we want to stay that way for the new renewal, shows you the increase.
I see that. $27.98.
And we were giving you an option to make it more family friendly, add $25 to the county extra pay, to where it's not that much of an increase for the employee.
But it's an increase into the county.
Correct, $4,000, which is in the budget.
It's in the budget for 2019.
Right.
Okay, but not going into 2020 then. Yeah.
You guys have another measure for 2020 yet?
Mm-hmm. Any other questions? We want to move on.
No, I'm going to let you two decide. I voted no, so I'm just going to bow out and let you two decide.
I'd like to see us use the family friendly rate. And cost percentage wise doesn't go up much. We spend a few more dollars. But we're helping a little bit on the family side. Which, you know, we've had concern about that family side for all the time I've been on the commission.
Yeah.
And this, you know,
it's been a concern to all the commissioners all the way through. That when we hear what you take $600 out of the employee's check out of there, right? Some of them, if they're making $20 an hour, it's not as bad as the ones making $13 an hour. But it's always been a family deal because, number one, we want to keep our employees. And not that us old timers, not that the old timers, we don't want to run them off to anyone, but you'd like to see some of your employees stick around. If you have good insurance, good, you know, fairly good coverage that they can afford, right? They'll buy it, and they'll stick around for a while. So I guess if that's the family-friendly way, why, and it's not a $27,000, that's per year over what we're spending today.
Yep. That's an increase. going to stay at 10%, but the dollars can change. Odd and sundry. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
Aye. And I'm going to say, the only reason I oppose it is because I believe we chose the totally wrong plan. We could have knocked out 50% of the employee contribution if we would have left the other plan. We could have really done the employees a better service, in my opinion. A much better plan at much less cost.
Do you have anything else? I think that's it, isn't it? Ashley, you have anything? Second that, all in favor?
Aye.
Hailing, so I guess we walk outside of that.
Well, health insurance is a big issue anymore.
Oh, yeah.
Always that up every year.